This tutorial covers the user interface enhancements introduced in version 1.8 of Kavo's iMod for simplifying the deployment of custom applications. This UI wizard overview is recorded using version 1.8 of iMod in December 2009. After login on the End Tier page, you will see three options for deploying systems under Deployment Options. They are Deploy from Template, Define New System, Import System. Two of these options, Define New System and Import System, are new. Let's look at Define New System first. Clicking on Define New System starts a UI wizard to simplify the process of deploying a new custom application in the cloud. In this example, we will demonstrate how to deploy a two-tier system with a web tier and an application tier across two different clouds as a single system using Kavo's application-centric management approach. Web tier will have one load balancer in Amazon EC2 and one load balancer in Rackspace Cloud. App tier will have two app servers in Amazon EC2 and two app servers in the Rackspace Cloud. Give a name to the system without using space or special characters. Enter the number of tiers for the system, and if needed, edit the default timeout value. In case there is any problem, iMod Engine will keep on trying to configure the system or perform the workflow till it is successful or the system or tier times out. Click Next. Let's first configure the web tier. Display Order 1 means tier will be displayed on the top. Deploy Order 2 means tier web tier will be configured after app tier. Deployment Order is used to handle deployment dependencies in multi-tier system. For multi-cloud deployment, add load balancer servers to be deployed in Rackspace Cloud and Amazon EC2. Click Next. Now configure the app tier. Display Order 2 means app tier will be displayed below the web tier. Deploy Order 1 means app tier will be configured before the web tier. Add app servers in Amazon EC2 and app servers to the Rackspace Cloud. Set the default startup count for each server role to 2. Min and max count specify the boundaries for scale up and scale down for the server roles during runtime. The wizard creates the system definition file. After deploying the system, you have to configure the servers. In version 1.8, you can only configure servers from the UI wizard. In future releases, we will add enhancement to make it easy to add and edit actions and events to the system definition file using the UI wizard. For information on configuring the system definition, please refer to documentation at wiki.kavo.com, and also check out the XSD file for the iMod system definition schema. After the system is fully configured, you can bring online the system deployed across multiple cloud providers with a single click. You can import system from the local file system. If we don't name the system before importing, the XML file name is used as the name of the system. You can export the system and download the file to the local drive by clicking on the Export button under the Definition tab. To provide more flexibility when deploying system from Kavo-provided system templates, we broke down the deploying from template process in two steps. In step 1, you only deploy the system from the template, and in step 2, you customize the deployed system for your cloud accounts. For configuring the system for your deployment, you can either use the UI wizard, or you can also manually edit the system. Please give us feedback after using the UI wizard on how we can further improve it. We will continue to improve the user interface and continue to make it easier for users to deploy, configure, and manage complex custom applications in public, private, and hybrid clouds.